are the future. We are the dream. We are the nation. We are part of this. Yes, we are so amazing. That's the least we shall be. At the heart of the nation, changing history.
The work of democracy, I've listened very closely, and in the discussions that preceded my speech, and I want to say that democracy is a very difficult concept to understand. It's also even more difficult to practice. Yes, we have very common understanding of what democracy is. Most common was that given by Abraham Lincoln during the Gettysburg Address, where he described democracy as a government of the people, by the people, and for the people. Most of the time we think it's as simple as that, but it's really not as simple as that. And if you look at the history of democracy itself, you'll find that it was a very unpopular form of government when it emerged under the Greek city-state of Athens at about the 5th century BC. At that time, democracy was in fact described by Aristotle as the worst form of government. And the reason is very simple. Because during that time when they were practicing democracy, there were certain features that we often don't talk about which characterized democracy at that time. At that time, women were not considered capable of participating in public debates. If you are not a male Athenian who has property, you are also not eligible to participate. Slaves are also not allowed to participate. Foreigners are also not allowed to participate. So it is, of course, to a very large extent, a very limited form of participation. But that's actually not the reason why democracy was discredited. The main reason why democracy was discredited was that it was compared with a form of rule that many people come to identify as the rule of the philosopher kings. Because democracy was considered by Aristotle as the rule of the mob. And because of that, those who were in power are considered to be people who are given to personal advertisement. And because of that, they oppose the engagement of Socrates trying to call on the youths to think for themselves and to challenge the system. Because of that, the politicians turned up and accused Socrates of corrupting the youth, and that was going to destroy the society. They brought him to trial and killed him. He was committed to death by poison. And the philosophers of that time thought that it was a great crime for intellectual activity.
Circle Studios.